But he found it not robbery to let me live another day. So I'm not ashamed of the Lord or to defend his cause. Yeah, they did him wrong. They abused him, my brothers and sisters. They called him all kind of names, my brothers and sisters. They didn't do Jesus right. He was an innocent man. But yet and still, they wanted to destroy him. They wanted to kill him. Matter of fact, they asked, can any good thing come out of Nazareth? But I am not ashamed of my Lord. And I'm not ashamed to defend his cause. And I know somebody out there say, well, maybe it ain't just you, but I just want to ask a question. Is there anybody that's out there that's not ashamed to give God some praise? Is there anybody ashamed to give God some honor? Yeah. Is there anybody out there that's not ashamed that want to just lift him up? Yeah. Anybody want to lift up the name of Jesus? I'm not ashamed to own my Lord or to defend his cause. Because I remember on a Monday about 7 p.m. 1987 and the Lord came into my heart. And the Lord saved my soul. And you know, the old saints used to teach the young saints that when Jesus did something for you, when Jesus saved you, the old saints used to say, I'm going to serve him to the day I die. Isn't that right? They say, I'm going to serve him to the day I die. These days and times, people give God a 30-day notice. If God ain't do nothing in 30 days, they tell him to get rid of him. Matter of fact, they even made a song, What Have You Done For Me Lately? But my brothers and sisters, God does something for us every day. And no matter what, I won't be ashamed of the Lord. I remember a long time ago when God had called me to preach, and I shared it with my mom, and I told my mom, I said, well, I'm not going to be like the rest. And that wasn't the rest of the preachers, that was the rest of the people that I was around. And I decided that because I changed partners and I didn't belong to the world no more, I was going to give God my very best. I was going to give God all of my might, give God all of my soul, give God all of my energy. And the minute you say that, I want you to know that the devil going to make you prove that. And my brothers and sisters, sometimes I've been up, and sometimes I've been down. Sometimes I've been understood, and sometimes I've been misunderstood. Sometimes I had trials, and sometimes I had tribulations. But I kept on marching because of this man called Jesus. I kept on holding on because of this man named Jesus. I kept on praising him because this man named Jesus. Whooping for you and me and never said a mom and boy. I don't know about you, but there anybody out there can testify about this Jesus? Anybody out there can lift up the name of Jesus? Anybody out there can give this Jesus some glory? Because he's worthy to be praised. Or to defend his cause, maintain the glory of his birth. I'm not ashamed. He woke me up this morning. I'm not ashamed. He healed my body. I'm not ashamed. He was my friend. I'm not ashamed. He was my friend over troubled water. I'm not ashamed to give him some glory. I'm not ashamed to lift him up. I'm not ashamed to give him some praise. Because he is worthy. He is worthy. He's worthy. He's my Alpha and my Omega. He's my secret weapon against the devil. Oh, Christ, the solid rock I stand. All of the ground is safe and sound. I'm not ashamed to own my Lord or to defend his cause. I'm not ashamed because I know if it was not for the Lord that was on my side, where would I be at? I'm not ashamed. I should have been dead and gone, but I'm still him. Still praising. Still giving him glory. Still giving him honor. Because he's almighty. I'm not ashamed. There's been a lot of things that I've been ashamed of. But I'm not ashamed. I'm not ashamed, oh my Lord, because it was his blood that made a difference on Calvary. I'm not ashamed, oh my Lord, because his blood washed all of my sins away. I'm not ashamed because he paid a debt for me. And my brothers and sisters, it was paid in full. What I like about Jesus is he didn't have to finance it. He paid it all in full. On the cross for me. As a matter of fact, every time I get a little bit down and every time I think about what Jesus has done to me, I know you're supposed to preach in church, but sometimes I have to preach in the backyard. And sometimes the devil get the best of me. And I say, well, let me tell you about a man named Jesus that was born in a place called Bethlehem. And even though you tried to embarrass Jesus, he never said a mumbling word. And I'm talking about the man Jesus that they hung him up on the cross, stretched him out real wide, hung him up real high. And my brothers and sisters, when they killed him, they thought it was all over. Somebody say he died on the first day and nothing happened. Somebody say he died on the second day and nothing happened. Somebody say he died. I say, oh Lord, he died. But on the third day, he got up with all power in his hands. And that's why I can't be ashamed. That's why I won't be ashamed. He kept on marching to a place called Golgotha, which means land of the skull. Can any good thing come out of Nazareth? I'm not ashamed when they say I'll never make it. I'm not ashamed when they outnumber me. I'm not ashamed when they close doors in my face. I'm not ashamed when it looks like I wasn't gonna make it. But my brothers and sisters, I'm not ashamed to own my Lord. I'm not ashamed to defend his cause because he's been there for me. How many people know he'll wipe tears from your eyes? He's been there. He's been there. How many people know in the midnight hour, sometimes you need somebody to talk to? And everybody's asleep. Nobody won't get up. But somebody told me that Jesus, he's on the main line. All you gotta do is dial him up. Tell him what you need. Sometimes your friends stray away. My brothers and sisters, Jesus, he'll stick closer than a brother. My brothers and sisters, sometimes Jesus can be your mom. Sometimes Jesus can be your father. But no matter what, as long as you got King Jesus, I don't need nobody else. As long as I got King Jesus, I'm gonna be all right. As long as I got King Jesus, no weapon formed against me shall prosper. As long as I got King Jesus, I know my door's gonna open. Just like Paul and Silas, they was all locked up. And they began to do some hymn songs, calling on the Lord. And how many people know when you call on the Lord? You know how that song break every chain? When you call on the Lord, every chain gonna break. When you call on the Lord, he'll undo the heavy burdens. When you call on the Lord, he'll break every yoke. When you call on the Lord, he'll loose all the bonds of wickedness. Does anybody know this Jesus? Does anybody know our Lord and Savior? He said, don't be ashamed of me when we round each other. Because there's a day coming that he's coming back. And you ain't gonna be able to feel. You ain't gonna even be able to tell no lies. Jesus is going to say, yeah, they was ashamed of me, and now it's time for me to come into my glory. And you know, this is an amazing thing. I say this and get ready to close. You know, Jesus, he don't need your debit card. He don't need the keys to your Cadillac. food that's in your refrigerator.
Jesus.
All he want to do is just give him a shout out and just say, Lord, I praise you. Lord, I give you the glory. And Lord, I give you the honor.
Yes.
Well, my brothers and sisters, I know God has been so good to me.
Yes.
You're looking at a person that had this hip replaced. Yes. And I thought I wasn't going to make it. That was the end of the world for me. And then he replaced this hip for me.
Yes.
And I kept on walking and kept on praising. Yes. I kept on giving him the glory. Yes. And never gave up. Now he replaced this knee.
Wow.
And I kept on moving on and kept on praising God. I know we're in church, but can I go down memory lane? Y'all just sit right there. I'm going down memory lane just for a minute. I remember when I was all the way in the back of the church, when I was ashamed of the Lord, when I sat on the last bench, and I didn't know that God was real. And one day he came into my heart, and one day he changed my ways. And then I moved from the back of the seat, and I got up into the middle. Sisters, I gave him just a little praise. I gave him just a little glory. And my brothers and sisters, it started raining in my life. Trouble started coming in my life. Trials started coming in my life. Tribulations started coming in my life. And I moved up just a little bit closer. But I kept on holding on. I kept on fighting the good fight. Because I'm a soldier in the army of the Lord. And my brothers and sisters, I got all the way to the front bench. But I still kept giving him some praises.
Yeah.
And I still kept giving him the glory. And I still kept giving him the honor. What a mighty Lord we serve. What a mighty God we serve. He's all right. He's my bread for the moment. He's my friend. He'll help me through trials. He'll help me through tribulations. Now, why I had to give that illustration that because I finally made it to the pulpit. You see, when you're at the pulpit, you sit up just a little bit high and you can look down on where you came from. But when you're on the pulpit, anybody can praise God. But my brothers and sisters, I came from the back of the church to the front of the church. And my brothers and sisters, I'm not ashamed to own my Lord. Because I know where my help comes from. Sometimes your money won't buy what you need to buy. But God knows just what you need. And my brothers and sisters, I don't care if you're in Florida. I don't care if you're in Georgia. Nobody don't have to make God pay child support. He knows how to take care of his children. My brothers and sisters, he's the wheel in the middle of the wheel. He's the bridge over troubled water. He's Alpha and he's Omega. He's the beginning and he is the end. And all you got to do, there's somebody right now that's just confused and don't understand why we act the way we act. But I just want to let you know, if you just break out of your shell and just give God a little bit of praises, I guarantee you your chains will fall off. If you just give him a little bit of glory, he'll help you. He'll help you. Because I know I used to be there. I used to then have faith in God. I used to think that God was not real. I used to think that Jesus was not real. But my brothers and sisters, when trouble knock on your door, when the Holy Spirit come in your life, and when you turn to the left and can't get no help, and turn to the right and can't get no help, and you can't depend on nobody but the Lord, you know that he brought you here. You know it, and all he want is glory. All he want is a little bit of honor. All he want it's just a little praise.
Yes.
And matter of fact, I'm going to close with this. He wants the kind of praise. Hold on to your seats for a minute. He wants the kind of praise that you give him at a FAMU game.
All right.
Okay. He wants the kind of praise that you give him at the Dallas Cowboy game.
Yeah.
Like it's the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
Some of y'all don't like Dallas. Y'all might like FSU.
Yeah.
But no matter what kind of praise you can give, he wants you to give him that kind of praise. Now, I'm going to just say this and I'm going to try to sit down. How you praise God determines on what kind of Jesus you have.
Wow.
I'm going to close with this. If you got to play, play Jesus, you got to play, play praise.
All right, all right.
My brothers and sisters, if you have a Jesus that's all power,
yes,
in his hands,
yes,
you got to praise, uh-huh, with all power, yes, from out your spirit,
yes,
back to him.
Uh-huh.
My brothers and sisters, if you got one of those praises that you don't think you're going to make it,
uh-huh,
my brothers and sisters, you could tell the difference with a praise that's saying, no weapon formed against me shall prosper.
Yes.
Greater is he that's in me than he that's in the world. Let me just close with this note, because I might not be able to see everybody. If you're a true worshiper, if you're a true praiser in the building, and you know that you praise God, if you know that you belong to Jesus, and it ain't no faking in your game, you don't mind just standing up for Jesus for a minute if you're not ashamed. And he said, Jesus was like camphor soup. He was good. How many people know that the Lord, he is good? And since you're on your foot, let's just give him up. Since you're on your foot, let's just give him some praise. And since you're on your foot, let's just give him some glory. Because he's worthy to be praised.
Yeah.